There's always money in the banana stand!
Welcome to IAYTD and welcome to What is Wednesday. Today I'm going to explain Arrested Development, a comedy television show that was canceled after 3 seasons, but was so beloved that it was revived by Netflix and may even have more seasons coming. This video will be a good nostalgia trip for those of you that know Arrested Development, but it's really intended for people that know nothing so they can understand why people might watch this show. So let's start at the beginning. Arrested Development began in 2003 and ended in 2006. It focused on a family called the Bluths. Its primary focus was the only functional adult in the entire family, Michael. In the opening episode, we discover that Michael thinks he's going to inherit his father's business, but instead is passed up. He must decide to either leave town or stay and selflessly help his family. Along for the journey is his son, George Michael, played by a then unknown Michael Cera. His mother passed away before the series, so it's just the boys. In charge of the Bluth Company when our show begins is George Bluth Sr., who is arrested in the first episode on all sorts of charges, which are slowly unveiled over the course of the show. Every character on the show has a few oddities. George Sr.'s mostly revolve around his prison lifestyle and his twin brother Oscar, who quite often gets mistaken for his incarcerated brother. When George is arrested, he leaves the company not to Michael, the responsible one, but to his wife Lucille. Her oddities include her alcoholism, her blunt honesty, and her general disrespect to anyone and everyone.
Anyway, it's a party, and I want the whole family there.
We're having a party?
No.
She begins by delegating responsibilities to her other children, all of whom fail miserably at what they were meant to do. That's where Michael decides to step in and help right the ship, as it were. Michael has an older brother that feels like running the business should be his job, even though he's dedicated his life to the art of performing tricks.
So, this is the magic trick, huh?
Illusion, Michael. Trick is something a whore does for money.
Or candy.
Sorry, illusions. This brother, named George Oscar Bluth, shortened to the acronym G-O-B, pronounced Job, though it should be pronounced Gob. At this point, the actor Will Arnett was a relative unknown as well. Arnett has a blast playing Job, who is constantly performing magic and even has a rivalry with fellow magician Tony Wonder, played by Ben Stiller. Michael also has a sister named Lindsay, who loves to spend money and hates to work, hence why she married a successful analyst and therapist.
Okay, Lindsay, are you forgetting that I was a professional twice over, an analyst and a therapist, the world's first analrypist?
Yes, and you're almost arrested for those business cards.
Tobias is probably one of the quirkiest characters on the show as a former therapist that now wants to become an actor and will do anything to get a role, though that is generally unsuccessful. He's also what's called a quote-unquote never nude, meaning he wears jean shorts under his pants, including when he showers. He is, as the name implies, never nude. Lindsay and Tobias did have a daughter named Maybe, who is clever and witty and uses manipulation to get what she wants from both her parents and from the world. Unfortunately, poor George Michael begins to have a crush on Maybe, even though she's his own cousin. He manages to forget her somewhat when he meets the absolutely odd girl named Anne.
Who?
Anne. You know, she's the girl I'm kind of hanging out with.
I haven't met Anne.
Yes, you have.
Michael had met Anne.
Let her in. That's her right over there.
She's got a little hard-boiled egg going there.
Oh, it's so cute. She sometimes takes a little pack of mayonnaise and she'll squirt it in her mouth all over, and then she'll take an egg and kind of she calls it a mayonnaise. Are you okay?
I don't feel so good.
Lastly, we have Michael's youngest brother, Buster. Buster is still connected to his mother, Lucille, and follows her everywhere and believes everything she says. He's very socially uncomfortable and is the catalyst for many of Arrested Development's outrageous plot lines, including where he dates a woman his mother's age, played by Liza Minnelli, who happens to also be named Lucille. And now we have the entire essential cast. Each 20-minute episode revolves around some small plot line, usually tied to the larger arc of saving the company and getting George Sr. out of prison. Each episode is also narrated by Ron Howard, who served as one of the executive producers on the show. With 3 seasons on television and a 4th straight to Netflix, the show is a very manageable binge watch. But what's unique about Arrested Development, you might ask? What separates this from other sitcoms? Arrested Development manages to somehow balance superficial puns and punchlines with incredibly witty and equally outrageous plots. It will create a joke that you don't even realize is a joke until episodes, even seasons later. Their ability to create memorable quotes is off the radar, more so than most other successful comedies.
I'll have the Ike and Tina tuna.
Plate or platter?
I don't understand the question, and I won't respond to it.
Then what would you like?
The website IGN.com even called Arrested Development the funniest show of all time. However, this ability to create long-running and inside jokes may have contributed to the show's early cancellation. Most half-hour comedies are mostly able to be watched out of order, and you should almost be able to jump in at any point without much context. However, since Arrested Development rewarded continuing viewers, it may have done a disservice to new viewers that are trying to get into the show. Another reason many people enjoyed Arrested Development was its ability to nab some incredible guest stars that would have potentially season-long or reoccurring roles, such as Charlize Theron, the Fonz himself, Henry Winkler, Amy Poehler, who used to be married to Will Arnett, Terry Crews, Martin Short, Seth Rogen, Kristen Wiig, Julia Louis-Dreyfus, and both Conan O'Brien and Andy Richter.
You know what else would be funny? If I ripped that red rug right off your head and turned you into Ron Howard.
The numbers for the show weren't great, but some of that falls back on Fox as a network. They changed the times around and they cut the last season short, even choosing to air the series finale opposite of the opening ceremony for the 2006 Winter Olympics. It did get its fair share of critical acclaim, however, including being nominated for many Emmys, including winning Best Outstanding Comedy for its first season. Time magazine even listed Arrested Development as one of the 100 best TV shows of all time, in no particular order. In 2013, the show was revived on Netflix for a fourth season, and a fifth season is seemingly underway, though it's unclear when it will arrive. Hopefully this was a fun trip for those of you that watched Arrested Development, and an informational one for those of you that missed it. It is still streaming on Netflix if this piqued your interest. Thanks for watching, and check back next Wednesday for another What Is.
We're making a gown. She's gonna be in a beauty pageant.
Yeah, who's Anne?
My girlfriend, she's... You've met her so many times.